What are the advantages and disadvantages of Autosar? Let's understand this topic in our today's video. Hello everyone, welcome to Link Frequency and I'm Aishwarya Pattar. This video is part of our course that is Introduction to Autosar. So without any further delay, let's get started. Now let us start with the advantages of Autosar. Sharing of software can be possible between different companies. Previously, the software module from different manufacturers cannot be merged or installed in one single ECU because each firm had its own software architecture. Thus, a single supplier had to create the entire software for the ECU. However, Autosar basic standard objectives resolved this issue, which made the software components independent. This gave the manufacturers and the OEMs the ability to choose the best software component from various sources and also integrate them in one single ECU. Moving on to the next advantage, that is reusability of the software component. Autosar made the software component independent of its hardware. So, software component can be used in any ECUs, which reduce the cost of development. The next advantage is time reduction. The development time was reduced by reusing the software component. This was made easier to develop the software for different vehicle models and configurations in short time. The next advantage is layer software architecture for BSW. The top layer of the Autosar was independent of the underlying layer, so the software need not have the complete detail of the hardware. Same software can be reused for different hardwares without changing the current functionality. The next advantage is improved quality. Due to standardized interfaces, there was reduction in the errors, which increased or improved the reliability of the software. Last but not the least, the last advantage is design flexibility was more. So, now I'll show you on the screen. Whatever I've discussed so far is visible on the screen. So, these were the general advantages which I could foresee and I've listed it down. I have also listed the different individual benefits that the manufacturers, OEMs or the tool developers will have. So, these are the benefits which individual people will be having. The first one is specific to OEM, the second one is specific to suppliers, and the third one is specific to tool developers. Now, let us move ahead and understand the disadvantages of Autosar. I could list down majorly two disadvantages of Autosar. The first one is complexity. It might be a bit difficult to understand the concept of Autosar initially, but once you comprehend, you will understand it in much easier way. The second major disadvantage is initial cost of investment is too high. No doubt, this can be turned into as advantages if you see the initial cost of investment is only once. Since we are reusing the software multiple times, that can also be an advantage if you see on the other side. These is also represented on the screen. Hence, you can see the disadvantages listed here, that is the complexity and initial investment. So these were the advantages and disadvantages of Autosar. Thank you so much for watching our video. I hope you could enjoy the video content. If there are any queries related to this video, you can surely comment down in the comment section. Until we meet on our next video, happy learning. Tune yourself to make a difference.